everybody is aware that a keyword search volume is a critical SEO metric. However, it is critical to understand what it takes to rank for that keyword. That is why each keyword research tool employs a metric known as keyword difficulty. We'll take a closer look at what it is, how it's calculated, and why it's critical while conducting keyword research in this tutorial. What is keyword difficulty? Keyword difficulty, a.k.a. keyword competition or SEO difficulty, is a search engine optimization metric that indicates how difficult it is to rank for a particular keyword. The more difficult the keyword, the tougher it is to rank on the first SERP due to the significant rivalry among ranking websites. Numerous factors, both external and internal, contribute to the level of keyword difficulty, including the quality of your competitors' pages and the quality of your own. Typically, the term is used in two slightly distinct ways. 1. The difficulty of a keyword is a metric on a scale of 0 to 100. 2. Keyword difficulty is a general term taking into account all the aspects, both internal and external. Now let us discuss each one in detail. Keyword difficulty is a metric. Frequently, the term keyword difficulty refers to the metric used in SEO tools to quantify the difficulty of ranking for each keyword on a scale of 0 to 100. The formula is straightforward: the higher the score, the more difficult it is to rank for the keyword. In KWfinder, for example, the difficulty scores are additionally color-coded to assist you in navigating through the list of keywords. How is keyword difficulty calculated? When converting a keywords competition into a statistic, only one aspect of the website's quality is considered: the backlink profile. Each website that appears on the first SERP is assigned a score depending on the quality and quantity of backlinks. Your competitor's authority can be quantified in a variety of ways. The link profile strength statistic in KWfinder estimates the quality of a website's link profile. The computation is based on the metrics chosen by Moz, Majestic, and other expertise, specifically domain authority, page authority, citation flow, trust flow. Following that, the average score is calculated to get a single final result indicating how difficult it is for a website to rank in the first SERP for this term. Keyword difficulty as a general term. When evaluating how difficult it will be for you to rank for a particular keyword, there are a few aspects to consider, both internal and external. The most critical factors are as follows. 1. Your competitors. SEO is all about outranking your competitors. Thus, examining rival websites is one of the most effective methods for estimating the difficulty of ranking for a term. You should place a premium on the following: content quality, on-page optimization, and backlinks. Backlinks remain a significant ranking factor and hence provide an accurate estimate of how difficult it will be to rank for a keyword. Additionally, it is the sole element that can be quantified and converted to a metric. That is why determining the keyword difficulty is sometimes reduced to determining your competitor's authority, as measured by their link profile. The greater the authority of the website's ranking for a keyword, the more difficult it will be to outrank them. 2. Authority of your website. Apart from your competition, the authority of your website plays a role in determining your potential to rank for a keyword. This is especially critical if you have a new website. Even if the competition for a keyword is minimal and you publish an excellent piece of content, your brand new site with no backlinks is unlikely to rank. Bear in mind that they are not used by Google in any manner and are provided only for your convenience. Ensure that you compare data inside a single metric. 3. Quality of your content. There is another side to the coin. Your website's authority will be useless if the quality of your content cannot compete with the page's ranking in the first SERP. You should consider the following. How difficult will it be for me to create content that is on a par with or better than that of the competitor's pages? Can I match my competitor's level of expertise? Is there any advantage I can supply my readers with over my competitors? All of these are subjective criteria that contribute to the overall difficulty of your particular term. 4. Search intent. Finally, and maybe most importantly, you should evaluate the search intent underlying the search query. In other words, what type of content are people looking for when they search a particular keyword? There are four fundamental categories of search intent. So, how can we ascertain the keyword's search intent? The simplest method is to reverse engineer it by examining the search results and determining the types of pages that rank for the phrase. Why should you care about the difficulty of a keyword? Numerous inexperienced bloggers select a keyword, compose compelling content, and optimize the website just to discover that they do not rank at all. The most frequently cited explanation is that competition is too intense. This is why your keyword research should always take keyword difficulty into account. By monitoring keyword difficulty, you'll get a decent sense of which keywords are hot and which players are huge in your niche. You'll be able to uncover more keywords in your niche for which you have a legitimate possibility of ranking. You'll save a lot of time by concentrating on keywords that will generate results even if your website does not currently have a lot of authority. How to use keyword difficulty in your SEO strategy. 1. Take a step back and consider the big picture. The difficulty of the keyword is merely one factor to consider while conducting keyword research. The other two critical factors are the keyword's popularity and relevancy. If the term has a low difficulty but no search volume, you will receive no traffic. On the other side, without relevance, even if the difficulty measure is low, you will not rank for the keyword because the search intent does not match your type of content. 2. Analyze the SERP results. Never rely on a single keyword tool's output. The keyword difficulty metric is intended to provide a fast snapshot. It is not intended to replace competitor research. In other words, SERP analysis is an indispensable component of SEO. Apart from the difficulty metric, constantly keep an eye on the SERPs and the real websites that rank for the phrase. You'll learn a great deal more about search intent, the type of content that ranks for the phrase, and the extent to which your competitors cover the subject. Additionally, you may note that the top places are occupied by major brands with a high authority, which may not be reflected in the 0 to 100 score but will impact your ability to rank for the phrase at the top. 3. Do not be afraid of challenging situations. The keyword difficulty metric should not be used in isolation to dissuade you from attempting to rank for a term with medium or high difficulty. It's more about gaining a general understanding of the competition and determining what has to be done to make your page a credible contender. Several factors can assist you in ranking for a highly competitive keyword. Outstanding content. You can outrank highly respected competitors by creating high-quality content that demonstrates greater expertise and delves far deeper into the subject. Topical relevance. Having a tightly focused website with high-quality internal links can help you outrank authoritative websites that cover the issue infrequently and are ranked mostly based on their overall brand authority. Backlinks of high quality. A large number of good quality backlinks to a single page will help you rank for that page even if your domain authority is lower overall. 4. Contrast the values contained within a single tool. There are numerous keyword research tools available, and each may utilize a different backlink database or calculate keyword difficulty differently. As a result, keyword difficulty scores may vary between tools, and it's critical to compare values within a single tool. Conclusion. I hope this video has helped you know what keyword difficulty is and why it is important in SEO and how you can use it in your SEO plan. Thanks for watching.